Hello, this is David from GeekThis.net. Today I'm going to show you how to use the process monitor in Windows. So we'll open up process monitor and we have to hit run since it's a single executable file. So once you have it open, this menu comes up. I'm going to just unselect everything. Oops. Or just hit reset. Then press OK. Now, I'm going to hit the capture button to cancel it, because once you start it, it starts capturing automatically. But I don't need all of this stuff right now because I want to monitor a single process. Once it finally stops, I'll clear the log. Okay, so now I have this test program. I don't know what it does, so let's find out. So it's waiting for input. So before I actually run the program, I'm gonna start capturing, go to Tools, Process Tree, and then these are all the processes your computer is running. I need to go find the one that I wanna monitor, which is this. So now I go to Include Process, Close. Okay, now it's filtered to only have that process. So once I do something, it shows up all the information that that process or program did. Now let's go through a quick walkthrough of it. First thing that happens is it gets information of the program. Then we see it's creating a file. If you want to hide the files, you use these tabs. This one has registry or shows registry activity, files, networking, thread activity, and profiling events. So we see that it's creating a file, and it's test.txt. We can open it and see more details on it. So it's going to overwrite the file. It has read and write access. So we'll close that. Then we see that it wrote to the file. It wrote 13 characters and had normal priority. You can't see the actual data that it wrote, though. And it closes the file. Now we see that it's opening up the registry. So we can see all the data that it pulled from the registry, and then it closed it. So that's how you monitor a single program. If you want to clear this, you can hit Control X. Then we can capture again. To capture all programs, you want to reset the filter. And once you're done, you just stop the capture, which is Control E. So that's how you can see what a single program's accessing. If you don't know what the program does, and you want to make sure it's safe, I would first scan it with a virus scanner and not go with this method. Because if you use this and it's a virus, it still will infect your computer. But you will be able to see what actually infected. So thanks for watching. You can see more tutorials at geekthis.net.